Season 5 is upon us! And that is pretty insane to think about. Not only that we've gone through 5 seasons already in Fortnite, but the quality of the content produced during those 5 seasons has been top tier. I mean, stuff that I personally haven't seen as good of development, and I have my qualms with the game, no questions. Have not seen as good of development in years from many other top tier devs. So Epic is absolutely murdering it right now in terms of releasing new content, fixing bugs. I wish they'd fix more. Again, I have my qualms, but that's not what today's video is about. Today's video, I'm in the playground mode if you couldn't tell, is over the season 5 news, some stuff that's happened in my hopes for season 5. I'm going to try to keep this under 7 or 8 minutes here because I don't feel like this needs to be 10 minutes for extra ads. I don't care. This is mainly to answer a lot of questions that people keep asking me of what I want from season 5, along with what I expect based off of the game. If you didn't know, if you look up in the sky, you can see the giant crack, but also there's some other holes in the sky now coming through. Like, that's just a crack in the dome above, it looks like, which is weird because a lot of people didn't think there was a dome. I don't know. It looks kind of like there is. I didn't think there was, personally, but if there was, how the fuck does the storm ever get in here? Like, that doesn't make any sense. Anyways, during this video, I could just walk around like an aimless fool, but I figured I'd also show you guys some tips and tricks with building. So pay attention, all right? First is the ramp plus wall combo. This is a simple basic trick. You do this a lot when you're just pushing people to make sure you can get height advantage over them without them breaking your stuff. You don't want to build too high typically because once you're above 3, you start taking fall damage. So typically 3 high is enough. Like, you go 1, 2, 3 and shoot at them. If they're shooting at your ramps while you're doing this, at any point you can peek over your ramp and shoot back. That's kind of the point. You force them to fire at you to knock you down. You take shots in their body, weaken them more. And you're going to see more tips and tricks here with building as we go. But I got to switch the talking topic here back to what I wanted. They've released llamas around the world in crazy places. A lot of YouTubers probably already posted videos over this because this was yesterday and they do news. And by news, all they do is steal content from Reddit and claim it as their own pretty much. They don't actually tell you where they get it from, but it's from Reddit. I'll tell you. You can go on there and you can see all this stuff before they ever post it if you'd like. On top of that, they released a strange looking like fox type mask and then a type of battle axe looking item today, yesterday and today, as like season 5 teaser screens. And between those two things, people are still assuming that time is going to be a major factor. One is because there have been things falling out of the rifts around the map. And by that, I mean, if you go around, you can find this old school anchor. I don't know what it's called in terms of a type of anchor. I haven't actually gone and looked at it. I've seen pictures. I didn't really care to go look at it. But yeah, you can see stuff like that. And I'm going to try to do a drop down play here. Didn't work perfect, but it worked okay. There are things that are appearing throughout the map, little things, small items that are dropped through these mini rifts, and the rifts that have been formed, not the big one up top, but the rifts that have been formed in retail or over the Tomato Town Tomato, the Durburger, whatever, over in Greasy Grove. And the Durburger showed up in real life as well, along with the llamas, out in the middle of a desert, which is pretty cool. Which makes you either think, hey, it's either a rift in space or time, or both. It could be both. Because if one thing transferred from the game to real life, you could conceivably say, all right, well, other things could be transferred from other dimensions or real life to the game. So that would be a rift in space, not a rift in time. But it could also be part of time. And people think that because the first teaser trailer yesterday was like, I guess I had to look it up again from Reddit. It looks like a Kitsune Yokai mask. And if you don't know what that is, trust me, you don't need to. I'll tell you the gist of it here. It's essentially a type of creature in ancient Japan that had some type of control over time. Whoa, I had a huge stutter there. This is the floor ramp combo, by the way. Floor wall ramp. It's a little bit beefier than what you saw before. This is the quick travel down. Oh, it's really quick when you do it that way. if you do that properly, it looks a lot better, but I accidentally missed a click there. Anyways, the yokai mask had something to do, the type of yokai mask alters time. So they're thinking, okay, and, you know, it's still something relative to time where things are going to be coming out of time, and the whole season 5 theme will be based on past, present, future type stuff. They can go back in time and you can look at Vikings, where like the second day they showed an interesting looking Viking battle axe, or people think it's a Viking origin, Norse origin, whatever. Or they could go toward the future and do futuristic stuff. Come here, llama, you're mine. You can go either way with that, truthfully. Get the llamas down, by the way, if they're stuck in a tree, shoot them, they'll go down on the ground. Another trick you need to know about sometimes. If you find a llama in a tree and it's stuck, that is the way to get it back. So people are heavily indebted into this time and space rift at this point. And personally, I do not want it to be a transference of time. Like, I don't want it to be a time rift. I don't want new stuff to show up on this map as the way it has been. I prefer, unless it's a way, okay, I'll tell you, there is an exception to this. I'd like a new map entirely. I think it's something entirely conceivable for them. And if they don't want to do a new map, what I would like is that the time rift, we'll call it, drops stuff into the map to make it a new map altogether, right? Whoops. Let's see if we can time this appropriately here. If you jump right when you're about to fall, right when you're about the peak of your jump and you're about to fall, you throw the impulse. That looked about right. There we go. That's another trick to get down. That's a bit harder to master, honestly. It took a lot of time to do that with me and Wildcat consistently dying. But, you know, it's an option. It's an option if you want to go for a cool play. So my dreams of it, what I'm looking for in Season 5 is a new map, or this map to be vastly changed, not just a divot. I don't even like the divot addition, honestly. But I would prefer if there was something very new to the map that made it either feel like a new map, or it was a new map entirely. Alrighty, now let's try the drop-down technique again. There we go. Easy enough there. Got it that time. That's more of an emergency drop-down technique. You don't have to do it unless you're in big trouble. And a lot of times what you can do is use a bouncer instead and bounce yourself off and take no fall damage. That's also an opportunity to get away in case you're too high. Those are very good items. In case you get too high up, you need to get down immediately. It's a great option. If I can find a llama, I'd like to show you guys another trick with a bouncer too, if I can. Where the heck is it? I'll find one, hopefully. Anyways, continuing. I prefer it was a new map overall. I'm not saying it needs to be a new shape and all new POIs, but I would like a lot of the POIs changed. And that's something that could happen with these time rifts. If a time rift in Greasy goes off and sucks all of Greasy Grove out and replaces it with something different, that's cool. That'd be cool with me. I think it'd be better if it was moved a little bit. Like, I don't want every POI to be in the exact same position as a time rift. I would like, you know, some of these, maybe Greasy Grove is sucked out, a time rift appears randomly over here, and now there's a new POI right here that's sucked in. So I'd like the map not just to change POIs, but also positions of POIs. Because that will change a lot of people's drop patterns and rotation patterns. Now, I don't think that a rift can affect Loot Lake or any of the large rivers, so those are probably going to stay if that's the case. If it's a new map, we might see something different. There's a llama. If it's a new map, we might have more opportunities for that, which is cool. But as far as the time method or the time approach to it, there's no way that a time rift could change the river. I doubt it. It's very unlikely. It's possible, because rivers do change over time, but I'm not going to say that's a definitive thing. All right, let's go for another little trick play here. Let's throw the pyramid strat board building up really quick. So the pyramid strat is meant to get over, if you can do it properly, is meant to get over people quicker. Ooh, I'm getting bad lag right now. Why am I lagging? So if somebody and yourself are going to meet up with each other at the same ramp level, like let's say the top of this ramp, you guys' ramps complete together, and you know that's coming, you can do a pyramid into a pyramid and pyramid off the top of theirs and block them down below, which is very beneficial. And another quick strat to get down if you are too high up and you're trying to do it immediately is a port-a-fort directly down. And you'll hit a tire, and that should save you. You have to be aiming straight down, though. Make sure you're aiming completely straight down. So, another strategy to get down if you need to. Grab this llama. Need some bouncers now. We have no bouncers. I'd like to show you the last trick here with bouncers if I can. I showed you the pyramids. I showed you the double ramp and the single ramp wall. I showed you the floor ramp wall strategy. You can try the double floor ramp. It's much, much, much harder. I'll try that in a second for you. But it's much harder to do. I'm still not getting any freaking bouncers, man. That sucks. So the double ramp is like that, pretty much. It's super hard. It's a lot of buttons to hit at once. Gosh, this is difficult. I mean, if you're doing this, you're really trying. Like, you're really trying. Usually it's a large amount of overkill. For most circumstances, you don't have to do that. A one will do just fine. But in twos and squads, doing a double isn't necessarily bad. It's just a lot of effort and not easy to pull off. Especially moving full speed. Yay, there's some bouncers. Sweet. Oh, I got some earlier somehow. Okay, never mind. So, I mean, that's kind of what I wanted to talk about Season 5. The things that have happened so far, rifts spawning around the map, sucking things out of the map and throwing things into it, stuff from the map being found in the real world, llamas being found around the world, which might signal that there's, you know, things popping into the game from other places in the world, and that's, I mean, you could find the Eiffel Tower over in Retail Row. That'd be pretty fucking cool, right? As I mentioned, it could be a rift in space, which not only transfers stuff from the game to real life, but from real life to the game. So it's totally possible. Alright. So the last little bit here is the bouncer trick. And you can do this two ways. You can go on a reverse, or just jump off and go for the dedicated ramp play. Like that. And then hit your trap and then activate it. That's one way to do it. It's a little bit easier, I'd say. You don't have to do rotations. But you're also really hoping that you don't mess up. And then there's also, I'm not going to go too high for this one, because this one's the hard part. Yeah, see, that's the hard part. It's a double ramp rotation, trap hit placement. And it's difficult for me, because my spin wheel is my trap. So to hit my, it's not like I have to click my spin wheel. So that's like why it's difficult. It's hard to click that. I wish I could change it, but I don't have a lot of other keys that would work in that situation. But there we go. Something simple like that. So you have to do a double, and then you have to rotate it back to the way you were looking. So, I mean, it has its advantage to not rotate and then just go for an all-in play where you do a jump off. And it still works out. But you do have to face away from your opponent for a second, and you also are kind of banking that you don't mess up. So those two things considered, it can be a little sketchy. But yeah, that's kind of the tricks I wanted to show you. Some simple stuff in the build. I think that's under 10 minutes. Still, we're good. But my dream is that it shows us a whole new map. I would like the POIs to change drastically in area, location, everything, size, what they are. Or I would like this map to be sucked into a different time zone, dimension, whatever, that changes the map entirely and it's a new map. Those are the two things I would really love for Season 5. And if that happens, that's awesome. Because that means we got two maps within a year of launch of Fortnite, pretty much. Well, almost. I think it's a little over a year, technically. Maybe it's coming up on 1 year. But that's pretty insane. It took, what, H1Z1. They haven't even done a new map yet. They changed their POIs horribly. It did not go well for them. Let's just say that. It took PUBG like 3 years to make a new map. If we can get two maps in 1 year of Fortnite, that is insane. Along with the fact that they've kept up with a lot of updates every week and month and done a lot of bug fixes here and there, that is impressive as shit. I look forward to seeing what happens in the next couple days. I will have videos out right when stuff happens as far as big changes in Season 5 reveal. Subscribe, watch if you want to come back and check it out. Until then, thank you guys for watching. Hope you learned something from the build tricks. And if you have any questions, feel free to ask in the comment section. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.